So good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Let me introduce myself. My name is Christophe Baudel. I am the Executive Project Director of Coral Source Project for the TGS Consortium made of TechnipFMC, JGC Corporation, and Samsung Heavy Industries. I am myself an employee of TechnipFMC. And of course, I would like to thank you, LNG Korea 2020, for inviting me, as well as Konaru Sekaragi, TDGV Deputy Project Director, in attending this and making this presentation. We will present you today, together with Konaru Sekaragi, what we believe are the key success factors of Coral Source Development Project. This project, as highlighted before by Juan Carlos Corral, is currently under construction at SHI Yard in Goje, South Korea. Engineering and procurement phase are now over, and sail away is planned end of 2021. Let us tell you first some basic information on both TechnipFMC and JGC companies. Technip Energy is a world-class EPC contractor with more than 60 years experience on the execution of onshore and offshore oil and gas projects with leading market position, an unrivaled product and technology portfolio. Technip Energy has demonstrated its ability to deliver the most complex project, Yamal project in Arctic being one of them. TechnipFMC Group, which includes, of course, Technip Energy, can combine both Technip Energy and Technip Subsea expertise and propose accordingly fully integrated FLNG solution with expertise on process and liquefaction, naval engineering and marinization, subsea components such as riser and flow lines, including flow engineering, flow assurance engineering, LNG transfer, modularization, and loading arms. TechnipFMC has a strong leadership in LNG project market. It has participated to projects representing more than 20% operating LNG capacity and has 60-year track record in LNG with the following iconic projects. First LNG project in 1964 in Algeria with Kigda. World largest LNG trains in Qatar, realized in JV with Shoda. Each train having a capacity of almost 8 million tons per year. And the largest Arctic project, Yamal LNG. TechnipFMC is a pioneer in FLNG technology with the world's first FLNG delivered to Petronas in Malaysia, Satu FLNG, and the world's largest floating vessel with Shell Prelude in Australia, and today, under construction, under execution, the new Frontier Eni Coral FLNG in Mozambique. TechnipFMC is a pioneer in modularization, building onshore LNG trains on an unprecedented scale with the current Arctic LNG project under execution. TechnipFMC is also offering solutions for next generation mid-scale LNG for smaller reserves between 1 and 3 million tons per year and next generation FLNG, engineering liquefaction plant in order to have a minimal footprint, split hull and topside construction and minimize module integration works.
Good afternoon. My name is Kuniharu Sakuragi. I'm JB Deputy Project Director. I would like to say thank you very much for the LNG Korea 2020 to give us such an opportunity to present our project. For the JGC, the last year, we established the JGC holding company. But the JGC origin was established in 1928. And we have completed more than 20,000 projects. And for the LNG experiences, we have participated more than one third LNG project in the world. And total train was 54 and 179 metric ton per annum was producing. So as for the new build offshore FLNG, there are the four, including the under construction, which is our Enicoro. But those four were the participate for the Technip FMC and JGC and Samsung. So means that we are the strong experience and also the pioneer for the FLNG business.
So let's come now to what is the FLNG concept, basically. So you all know, of course, the onshore liquefaction plant. We start with gas extracted from wellheads. Then gas is dehydrated, compressed and injected into a pipeline, an underwater pipeline. Then, of course, it is brought onshore to a slug catcher, pre-treated in order afterwards to be liquefied and stored, and then it will be shipped through a jetty and an LNG carrier. So this is for a base load onshore LNG plant. Of course, for an offshore FLNG, basically what I would call LNG FPSO, the situation is quite different. Gas is directly extracted from the wellhead and sent to the FPSO, to the offshore facility, where it is pre-treated, liquefied, and stored inside the FLNG itself, in order later on to be shipped through an LNG carrier. So the scheme is, of course, much more simple. So what are the advantages of the FLNG offshore solution? In fact, there are many advantages. The first one is, of course, to treat, liquefy, store, and offload natural gas under, of course, liquid status directly at the offshore location, avoiding costly pipeline, truck line, and offshore compression, which can be very costly. It is therefore suitable for further, deeper, and stranded gas reserves. Of course, having an FLNG avoids to costly construction cost, where manpower can be in countries where manpower can be very expensive. This is also a movable asset. Some of our clients have already moved an FLNG built a few years ago. It can be so redeployed. Basically, it enables also oil production with monetization of associated gas rather than reinjecting or flaring this associated gas. A very important aspect is also, of course, no environmental impact on coastline. You know, of course, that onshore plants can be very detrimental to the environment. And of course, this requires to have construction in specialized shipyards. So a lot of advantages, in summary, for the FLNG solution. Of course, building an LNG plant offshore comprises challenges which can be overcome. To give you an idea of the magnitude of efforts to be realized in terms of design to build an LNG plant offshore, Prelude FLNG is 1/7 the area used for Yemen LNG per million ton per year. So the effort in size reduction is considerable. Volume and weight optimization are therefore key to move an LNG plant offshore. Challenges are in terms of safety, layout, module complexity, motions, and of course weight control. Each FLNG requires to find the right balance between safety, capex, opex, hull size and topside footprint, performance and availability, all this under, of course, an iterative process. But these challenges that I've listed are not the only one. Of course, on technical standpoint, we have many other challenges, either in naval and mechanical, marinization and constructability. For naval and mechanical, LNG liquid motion in tanks over 25 years without dry docking have to be mitigated. Offloading of LNG between two vessels in open sea is to be studied. For marinization, the challenges are essentially the compact design development of equipment, the design of equipment for motions, critical equipment design to be validated by CFD studies. And last but not least, these challenges need to overcome, of course, while meeting associated performance criteria of our clients. As for constructability, challenges are the size of equipment, which, as you are certainly aware, in LNG plants are larger and heavier than in any other oil facilities. Large bore and heavy wall piping have to be used, hull dimension and LNG cargo containment integration, as well as design of modules need to be done in accordance, of course, with the construction yard capability and lifting capacity.
And this shows the major liquefaction process. Depends on the capacity, that we are selected several process. And over the two MTPA, as an onshore project, we are normally utilize a propane pre-cool process. And small scale, we are utilizing the single MR process. However, to question about the FLNG, we need to think about the safety. So that's why the Petronas 1 and 2 project is applying for the nitrogen expander process to avoid the flammable gas. And our project utilizes the DMR process, which is limited to utilize for the propane.
So coming back to Coral South development project, a brief overview, because Juan Carlos Coral has previously given you basically many details on what is Coral project. Coral project is located in high water depth, approximately 2,000 meters, 80 kilometers offshore the coast of Mozambique, in the northern part of what is called Area 4, and is a perfect example of, let's say, suitability of the FLNG solution for such gas reserves. Coral FLNG, needless to remind, is of course a huge vessel, slightly smaller than Prelude. We'll see a comparison table after. But as you can see on this slide, much taller than other big, let's say, iconic buildings that you have in mind, such as the Eiffel Tower, and even, of course, much bigger than US aircraft carrier. We have summarized on this table, basically, the key characteristic of previous FLNG project. Coral, of course, under execution, PFLNG2, Prelude, and PFLNG1. PFLNG1 and PFLNG2 have been both realized for Petronas, and Prelude for Shell. So you can see that FLNG, any FLNG capacity is fully comparable with Prelude, with a little bit less than 3.4 million tons per annum. Difference between any FLNG and Prelude being that we have on Coral much less condensate, basically with only 400 cubic meters per day instead of nearly 5,000 for Prelude. As said by Sakura Xian earlier, we are using as an LNG process APCI DMR. The acid gas removal process is from BASF. Hull dimension, of course, 424 meters long, so a little bit lower than Prelude. We have 12 modules plus one flare module, representing a little bit less than 60,000 metric tons of module. We have eight LNG tanks. The mooring system, which is a very and delicate component system, is an internal turret made by Sofec. Offloading is side by side for LNG and by for condensate tandem offloading.
So this is a split of work for the Coral FLNG project. So the blue part is a technical FFMC had designed, and the red part is JGC had designed, and the yellow part is SHI designed. So that means inlet section of the gas treatment will be done by the JGC, and the liquefaction process will be done by technical FFMC. And this is a geographic split of work. So we split modules like this.
So now this huge Coral project is executed under many operating centers. In fact, for the consortium, in terms of operating centers, we can count seven of them, which have gathered at peak several thousand of engineers and technicians, using the most up-to-date communication and design tools, sharing databases and 3D models in real time. The directorate was based during the engineering and procurement phase was based in Paris, whereas now, with the shift of center of gravity in Gojae, the directorate is now, of course, in Gojae. In terms of construction site, basically construction was performed by TGS in several locations across the world. This map does not show, of course, all the locations of the dozens of suppliers involved across the globe. Main construction sites were in Singapore for the turret mooring system, in Korea for the FLNG itself, in China for the flare bore, and in France for the manufacturing of low lines and risers by Technip FMC.
As Juan Carlos-san mentioned, that one of the key success factors is engineering and procurement. So I will inform for the what we have done. As I said, that we have already three FLNG experiences before to build any coral. And we have a lot of lessons learned, and also the, including bad experiences. So before starting this project, the Technip FMC and the JGC has thinking how to contribute to the E and P to the E construction. So our object was the on-time delivery for the drawing of the material, and also the no design change policy with high maturity and quality. This is the main point, achieve this objective. But we have some challenges. One is a culture difference. As you can see that we have a multinational project and we have multinational location for the design. For example, the Technip FMC call section is designed at Paris, and hot section was designed by Yokohama, and the hard section was designed in Korea. And also those are the challenges. And executive strategy is, of course, we have to the good relationship and the close communication, even the dedicated area. And a resident to be allocated in each operation center. And this is one of the important point, is the friendly construction. To achieve the friendly construction, we have a strong the constructability and operability input into the design. Otherwise, in the future, we may have the major changes. And maximize the lesson learned, and we are assigning for the competent and experienced engineers from the, our project, previous project. And this also the one of the important point is we are utilizing the 3D model as much as we can instead of the drawings. Because we can do the seamless design within the engineering company and the shipping SHI. And also the early start of the fabrication drawing, we are discuss with the SHI and agree for the starting early start of the production of the fabrication drawing with hold management. This is also the first time to apply for the FLNG project. To make the high maturity, as Juan Carlos-san said, that we have conducted a pre-FEED and pre-EPCIC. That means that we have to place a PO as much as we can earlier than start of the project. And the achievement. Achievement, finally we achieved for the meter delivery for the drawing and material, and also the high quality and maturity has obtained. Therefore, currently, we believe that our design is a friendly construction design. This chart showing the comparison from with the similar scale conventional project and initial stage of the coral project and current actual. So you can see that how we optimize the schedule. However, to do this, short-term schedule with high maturity, we have a lot of difficulty because the vendor data is the most important to get a high maturity. We have the 700 equipment and also the over the 90 vendors. So we need to the all the farm data from those vendors on time. However, sometimes it's quite difficult. So for the engineering side, we'll do the try and error to utilize the preliminary design. So however, to increase the, our manpower, we have finally achieved for the shortened duration for the deliverable. And finally, we have the almost 3 months the shortened schedule obtained. Of course, this kind of schedule cannot be achieved without support from the company and also the SHI. But this is one of the benchmark for our future project.
So we hope we have given you a better insight on why Coral Source project is currently successfully executed. And of course, you have seen also the presentation of Juan Carlos Coral. Above all aspects which make a project a success, as we said earlier, lesson learned from previous project, pre-PCIC period, I would like to emphasize that the most important one is a collaborative approach and teamwork among all the teams of the consortium and company from, let's say, starting from the pre-PCIC period. And this has allowed to overcome, as you can imagine, all the numerous challenges a project like Coral in its complexity can raise, and of course all the difficulties and all this in the interest of the project. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.